Good morning everyone, I am Dhananjay Singh. This is my lecture number 5, subject physical education, class 12, chapter number 3, yoga and lifestyle, right? So we are going to start with the subtopic 3.5 in this lecture, which is hypertension, procedure, benefit and contraindication of preventive asana, right? Before starting doing or studying asana, we are going to study what hypertension is. Hypertension is also known as high blood pressure, and it is a long-term medical condition in which the blood pressure in the artery is persistently elevated. Right? So, hypertension is also known as high blood pressure, and it mostly occurs when the pressure in the arteries is increased, right? There are two types of blood pressure. One is systolic blood pressure. The top number refers to the amount of pressure in your arteries during the contraction of your heart muscle. And this is known as systolic pressure, right? As you can see, I have also written here 120 by 80 mmHg is 120 is a top number is systolic pressure, and it is shown when the heart contract in the pump out the blood outside the heart, that time that pressure is known as systolic pressure, right? And the other one is the bottom number, refer to your blood pressure when your heart muscle is between beats. This is called systolic pressure, right? Here you can see number 80, that is the bottom number when refer the diastolic pressure, and in between every contraction of the heart, or you can say in between every beat of the heart, there is a simple pause, and that pause is the systolic pressure, right? Now we can also say that the normal blood pressure of an adult is considered 120 by 80 mmHg, right? A person whose blood pressure reading are behind 140 by 90 mmHg is said to be having hypertension, right? So now we are going to study about the asana, which help as preventive and curing is hypertension. The first asana is Tadasana. The procedure is stand up in attention position, lift your arm upward, straight your hand upward, raise your heel and come on your toes. Also pull up your body upward. After some time, breathe out slowly and come to the previous position. Repeat the same exercise 10 or 15 times, right? The benefits are, the first benefit, it is helpful in developing physical and mental balance, right? As while performing this asana, we have to stand on toe. It is a very important for us to maintain the balance, and for performing this asana, we have to concentrate and focus depend on body, that why it is helping in developing physical and mental balance, right? Second, it reduce obesity. Third, it cure constipation. Fourth, it cure digestive problem. Fifth, it improve body postures. Means any kind of body deformity or physical deformity, it might be kyphosis, lordosis, scoliosis, flat foot, it might be blow leg, all those kind of deformity are cured or prevented by this asana and through that body posture, right? 6. It elevates sciatica. 7. It is an excellent asana for those who want to enhance their heights, right? 8. It is a beneficial in treating hypertension, right? Contraindication are, if you have low blood pressure, you should not do this asana, right? In case of headache or insomnia, you should avoid doing this asana, right? At last, individual who suffer from blood circulation problem such as faulty valves should not perform this asana, right? Now the second asana is Vajrasana. The procedure is, it is a meditative asana, kneel down on the ground or floor with your knee, ankle and toe touching the ground. Your toes will be straight backward. Now place your palm of your hands on the knee. The upper body should be straight. At this time, the breathing should be deep, even and slow. Then expand your chest forward and pull your abdominal portion inward. Right? Now the benefits. The first benefit is, it is a helpful in improving concentration. Now it is a meditative asana. It helps in better focus. It helps in enhance the concentration of a individual. Right? Second benefit, it is helpful in curing dysentery, back pain and chest disease. Right? Third, it enhances memory power. Fourth, it alleviates the problem related to menstruation. Right? Fifth, it removes mental stress. Feel relaxed not only by the body, you also feel by the mind. That is the reason why you feel less stress or there was no mental stress. Right? Sixth, it strengthens the pelvic muscle. 7. It cures postural deformity. Yes, there are a lot of postural deformity which are actually removed with the help of the asana. Right? 8. It prevents hernia and helps to relieve piles. Right? Last, it is the best asana for people suffering from sciatica and sacral infection. Right? Contraindication. A person suffering from joint pain should not be performed Vajrasana. Right? Means, joint pain is basic. You can talking about knee pain. Actually, the pain is the knee joint because you have sit in the longer period of time and whole of the body weight on the floor that time. That why, if any body should suffer joint pain, must not perform this asana. Right? Second, the individual who have any spinal column problem should not perform Vajrasana. Last, the individual who has some difficulty in movement should practice Vajrasana with a lot of care. Right? The third asana is Pavan Mukta Asana. The procedure is, lay down on your back on a plain surface, keep your feet together and place your arm beside your body. Take a deep breath. When you exhale, bring your knee towards your chest. At the same time, press your thigh on your abdomen. Clap your hand around your leg. Hold the asana when you breathe normally. Every time you inhale, ensure that you loosen the grip. Exhale and release the pose after you rock and roll from side to side about 3 times. Right? The benefits of Pavan Mukta Asana. The first benefit is, it eases the tension in lower back. Second, it enhances the blood circulation in pelvic area. Third, it helps in reducing the fat of thigh, buttock and abdominal area. Fourth, it strengthens the abdominal muscle. It also massages the intestine and organ of the digestive system, which help in releasing the gas and thus improve digestion. Fifth, relieve constipation. The contraindication of Pavan Mukta Asana is, the first contraindication, if you are suffering from heart problem, hyperacidity, high blood pressure, synaptic discs and hernia, you should avoid this asana. Second, pregnant women should avoid doing this asana. Third, if you have an abdominal surgery recently, you should avoid doing this asana. Fourth, individuals suffering from piles should avoid this asana. Right? The fourth asana is Adha Chakra Asana. The procedure is stand straight with both feet together. Hold your hip with your hand. Bend backward without bending your knee with slow inhalation. Remain in this pose for some time. Do it 2 or 3 times. Right? The benefits of Adha Chakrasana. The first benefit is it helps to make ankle, thigh, shoulder, chest, spine and abdomen stronger. Second, it relieves stress and tensions. Third, it improves digestion. Fourth, it cures menstruation disorders. Fifth, it cures pain in leg. Sixth, it reduces fat in the wrist and thigh. Seventh, it helps to alleviate upper back pain. It relieves stress in neck and shoulders. Right? The contraindication of Adha Chakrasana is, first, avoid performing this asana if you have migraine, headache, low blood pressure, diarrhea and insomnia. Right? Second, avoid doing this asana if you have peptic ulcer and hernia. Third, avoid this asana in case of hip or spinal problems. Fourth, pregnant women should avoid doing this asana. Right? The fifth asana is Bhujangasana. The procedure of Bhujangasana is, in this asana, the shape of the body remains like a snake. That is why called Bhujangasana. So the final position of the body look like a snake. Now, in order to perform this asana, lay down on the belly on the ground. Keep your hand near the shoulder. Keep your leg close together. Now, stretch up your arm slowly. Raise the chest. Your head should be backward. Keep in this position for some time. Then get back to the formal position. For good result, perform this asana 3 to 5 times. Right? Now the benefits and contraindication of the asana. The first benefit is it elevates obesity. So this asana helps in reducing the body fat, the extra body fat in the body. Right? Second, it provides strength and agility. Third, it gives relief from the disorder of urinary bladder. Fourth, it removes the disease of liver. Fifth, it improves blood circulation. Sixth, it makes the vertebral column flexible and thin. Seventh, it cures gas disorder, constipation and indigestion. Eighth, it strengthens the muscle of hands. Now the contraindication of Bhujangasana is, first, this asana should be avoided by individual who suffer from hernia, back injury, headache and recent abdominal surgery. Second, pregnant women should not perform this asana. Right? The last asana in your is Shavasana. The procedure is lay down in supine position. Legs should be straight. Keep the arm away from the body. Leave all the limbs loose as well as relax. Gradually breathe in deeply. Close your eyes and think that your whole body is becoming loose. Feel a complete relaxation in your body. Remain in this position for 10 to 12 minutes. Right? The benefit of Shavasana is, the first, it strengthens the nervous system. It controls high blood pressure. Third, it relieves mental tension. Fourth, it gives new vigor to both mind and body stimulatingly. Fifth, it regulates blood circulation and gives relief in various arts and pains. Sixth, it cures many psychometric problems. Seventh, it helps to cure many cardiac problems. Eighth, it relaxes and calms the complete body. Ninth, it improves concentration and memory. Tenth, it increases energy levels. Last, the body relaxes and goes into a deep meditative state, which in turn repairs the cell and tissue and releases stress. Right? So, Shavasana has a lot of benefits. So, Shavasana has both mental and physical benefits. Right?